I should tell that. And then sports to me was a way of not being bullied, or not being bullied and not feeling rejected, you know.
So I
started with team sports.
Yeah.
But I liked to fight too much. I was too competitive, you know, and I hit the other kids. And
yeah.
In soccer, I put my elbows to people, and you know, it's kind of like a.
I played every sport as well. I played a bit of soccer, a bit of basketball, just every sport I could get my hand on, really. But boxing was just a sport I absolutely loved, and boxing was a sport that really just took hold of my heart from the very, very start.
You know, they sent me a lot of things about your career, and I knew before. By the way, I want to see the documentary. I don't know, where can I download it? There's not YouTube. There's nowhere I can find it. Where can I find it?
I think it is on Netflix, but it's only on Netflix in the UK. But I'm hoping that it's going to be on Netflix USA soon. But we should. I have got a few DVDs of. I should. I'll
definitely... I want to see one. I want to see one.
Yeah.
You know, now that we were talking about, you know, Iron Man, I got to show you. Wait a second. I'm just going to flip my screen.
Yeah. Well,
there you go. That's my bike. My training bike. This is my training bike, but I keep it with me in the office.
Yeah.
And that's my my track competition bike that I used to do. That's a WBA belt, by the way. I think you fought in that. No, you didn't fight in that guy. And those are my medals.
Well, from the Ironman.
That's when you won the title.
Yeah.
That's when you won. That was in Cardiff, I think so.
Yeah.
I think so. That's when you won the title, right? Yeah. I took this picture.
And Sanchez. Yeah, exactly.
Yeah. That was in Cardiff. This picture was in Cardiff. So this went viral because they say I was disrespecting everybody in TV because I was taking a selfie that everybody knows. And this is my collection from the Ironman. So it's like, I don't know where's your belt case is. but those are my belts. These are my belts.
Yeah.
But the ones that mean more to me, wait a second, it's this one.
Yeah.
I qualified for a world championship at I was 42. It was the division is 40 to 44. Oh, this is Linares, by the way. and this one means a lot to me also because that was when my father passed. I promised myself I had to do a marathon.
Wow, that's amazing. Gosh.
Yeah.
That's a nice reflection.
And that was a way I could somehow be connected with my dad when I had the grief, you know. Talking about that, because this is one question I have to ask you. Not about football or whatever it is. Well, wait a second. For American soccer. For American soccer, we got to say that. what you know, I read that it was very difficult for you. Actually, it was reflected on your records, but many people don't know exactly what happened. You know, you after being such a standout in the amateurs, you losing to a girl that you beat four times, you know, Yoka's wife or Yoka's what's her name?
Mosley.
Yeah, Mosley, that yes. But you know, you beat her like three times in a row, and then you lose with her, and then you lose, you know, in the quarterfinals. What exactly happened, Katie? I need to know it. You know, I don't know if you can share it.
Yeah.
I know you broke up with your dad and everything else, but I need to know it, if it's possible.
I have a fantastic relationship with my dad still to this day, but just during that time, it was just such a difficult time for me personally as well as everything else, and I just wasn't boxing well at the moment. I don't know if there's anything else I can say. I wasn't myself in the ring, and I lost a bit of my confidence, I think, as well during that year. In 2016, I just had a really bad year in the ring, and after the Rio Olympics, I knew I had to change a few things, and that's when I decided to turn pro. And I look back in 2016 now, and I think that it really was such a tough year. But I wouldn't be where I am today if it wasn't for that year as well. yeah, I had to pick myself back up and build from those losses, and I'm really proud of that over the last few years.
Okay, so it's like fame came into your head,
No,
or
definitely not fame. No, I think it was just I just wasn't boxing well. I just took a bit of a dip in my boxing career. I was obviously unbeaten for so long in the amateurs, I think, for 5 years, and 2016 was just a particularly bad year for me for whatever reason.
okay. Got it, because at some point, when I was starting to achieve many things, I lost my head a little bit. I think, and I had my own fights with my dad as well. A lot of arguments. This is fun. Perhaps people don't know this, but I was not meant to work in boxing, never. I'm an engineer and an attorney, a lawyer. And I was working in a different company, and I pushed myself with my dad. At the end, we ended up working together, and it was kind of crazy.
Is your dad was the head?
Yeah, for 33 years. It
Well, yeah.
was a lot of time.
That's cool. Yeah. Yeah.
You know what? I'm surprised that you're such a nice girl. Don't talk too much. You're always like kind of shy.
Yeah, right.
And you got all these girls. I want to take your head off. You got a girl from Spain called Miriam. I was speaking with Jelena Mirjanovic. She wants to fight you. You got Serrano wants to fight you. I mean, this is crazy. I mean, how can you keep up with
Yeah, I mean, I can only fight one girl at a time.
that?
But yeah, I mean, it's great to have so many big fights out there available. It's fantastic. I don't women's boxing is on such a high right now. There's so many amazing fighters out there. There's so many great fights that people are genuinely interested in. We really are seeing the best of women's boxing right now, which is fantastic. But obviously my next fight is against Amanda Serrano, and that's I think one of the biggest fights in women's boxing history, so I'm really, really excited about that.
One thing my father would love from you is that you don't talk, you do.
Yeah.
You make things happen, and that's one thing. I like the fact that you came up back and became, you're right now there, because I don't judge. I know you're in the top, like Teresa and you are one of the top main fighters right now, along with Cecilia, I think so. Who
Exactly.
are your top fighters besides you, by the way?
Besides me?
Yeah, of course. I know you wouldn't say you're number
Oh,
one,
no, I wouldn't say I'm number one. No, I'd say in women's boxing right now, Clarissa Shields, Cecilia Bracos, and Amanda Serrano. I think those three are would be considered the top three or four for sure.
will happen after you fight Serrano? You beat her. What will be your next step?
Yeah, I mean, there's obviously talks of me fighting Cecilia Bracos as well. She's also an undisputed champion. In the welterweight, so could you imagine be a champion against the history fight? And obviously, the rematch we're pursuing as well is has to happen at some stage as well. So there are three, and I'm really delighted to be in this position. But obviously, my main focus right now. And Serrano, he's the only one. He's the only girl right now.
So you're not afraid of going 147?
No, I if that's the fight that people are interested in, I'd be very, very happy. I think the fight's going to be made at a catch weight. I don't think it's going to be at 147. Maybe Cecilia will come down to maybe 142 or 143 or something like that. But well, I guess we'll talk about that after the Serrano fight. But yeah, that'll be a very, very interesting fight.
How do you see that fight with Amanda?
But yeah, it's going to be a great fight. She's a very technically sound. She's a very good fighter, obviously a southpaw as well. So it's going to be an exciting fight, and I think it is going. You are going to see the best of women's boxing in this fight.
Well, it's gonna be, which fight would be stronger? You think Delphine stronger, or you think Amanda being strong and technical would be a tougher fight?
I don't know. I think they're both very different. Both very different opponents. I think they both come with different challenges. It's hard to say which one than the other. I think definitely is going. But I am going to be going into every single fight, and every time I step into the ring, I feel like I am. I'm always 100% confident that I'm going to come away with the victory. So, regardless of who it is, whether it's Amanda Serrano or Prasoon or Brackhouse, I am confident that I'm going to come away with a great win.
What's the day for you besides boxing?
What's your
hobby? Or you only box and that's it?
I have a great group of friends over here. I live a very simple life, actually. I go for walks. I love doing a bit of reading, watching a bit of Netflix, just normal things, really.
Just normal things?
Nothing too. Yeah.
I'll tell you, I do a lot of PlayStation.
You do?
I play a lot of PlayStation. I do FIFA all the time.
I don't play computer games at all. I wouldn't know how to play that.
You got a question here. Which was your favorite book?
Oh, my favorite book. That's a good question, actually. I'm reading a great book at the moment about prayer. Actually, I love reading Christian books. John Eldridge is probably my favorite author. So his books are amazing. One of his other books is called Beautiful Outlaw, and that was one of my favorite books of all time, actually.
Okay. My favorite book is 100 Years of Solitude. It's Gabriel Garcia Marquez. It's a Colombian writer. I don't know if you heard of him. You know, he won a Nobel Prize.
Right.
I just don't remember which year. And my favorite reading would be boxing. Yeah. I go back to many stories of boxing. Yes.
Yeah.
Actually, there's a story about Jack London. It's called For a Piece of Meat. You should read it. It's quite short and very nice.
Really nice. Give that a read. Yeah.
So I had a question for you. So you were a soccer player and a boxer at the same time?
Yes. Yeah. I played soccer from 8 or 9 years of age, and I actually played for Ireland for a few times as well. But I had to stop, obviously, in my early 20s. I had to make a decision. I had to step away from the soccer to actually just focus on boxing. So that was a big decision for me, because soccer was a huge part of my life as well.
I see. And one question. Wait a second. You know, I have, I love dogs.
Yeah.
My wife rescued dogs. Remember, I'm vegan, actually.
Yeah,
you know, and then let me show you one thing. Let me show you one thing. Wait. See?
Gorgeous.
Yeah, that's one of my daughters.
Beautiful. Yeah.
We rescue dogs, and the German Shepherd that you saw there was rescued by her. She goes to veterinarian school as well right now. She's the oldest of the daughters. The oldest.
Yes.
Yeah, she's 20. They just came into my office, so it's no problem. I'm vegan, by the way. I'm vegan. I do it for compassion, specifically.
Nice, yeah.
Yeah, we have a shelter here in Colombia, because I'm Venezuelan, but I live in Colombia.
Right.
So we rescue dogs. We rescue cats as well. And you know, it's came part of our life. My wife started, and then since that point on, basically all the family is doing it.
Yeah, amazing.
So what you saw there is, one of the dogs, you see, it didn't have one of the legs. Well, we call the arms. We're waiting to make a surgery for her and get a prosthesis and do whatever. Yeah.
Yeah. Stay home there. Yeah.
Yes. Yeah. So wait a minute. They got my attention, because I had a question regarding soccer. Which position do you like to play?
In soccer, I used to play center midfield. I played all the way up until my early 20s, as I said. But my one passion. I also love playing soccer.
Yeah, I like defense, you know. I always like defense.
Like tackles.
Yeah, I did love the tackles a lot. I did like the tackles a lot. And oh, then my son, then my oldest son is also got connected saying hello.
Oh, hi. Yeah, cool.
I got to tell you a secret. My assistant has a big crush on you. All the time he sees me, he says, he wants me all the time. He said, please tell Katie to send me a video message, you know.
Oh, that's lovely. Yeah. What's his name?
Juancho, Juan Francisco. Yeah. Later, please send it to him because otherwise he's going to kill me.
Yeah, I will. Thank you.
So how far are you from Dublin?
I live in a town called Bray, which is around,
yes,
which is around 30 minutes from Dublin. So it's not too far away at all. But right now I'm actually in Connecticut in America for the last few months in preparation. I'm obviously in the middle of training camp right now. So I'm based in Connecticut for all of my training camp.
I was checking Bray. I saw that you have a lot of green there.
Yeah.
A lot of castles, a lot of things.
Yeah, Ireland is full of green. And Bray is actually a lovely town. It's right beside the ocean as well. So it's a really, really nice place to live. I love it there. I definitely miss Bray. Yeah, every time I'm out here, I miss my family and stuff. I suppose.
Yeah, I've seen that in your fights. Your family, they're a big support for you.
God, yeah, I would be nowhere without my family. I think I don't think it's possible for me to be any more supported or any more encouraged by my family. They're my biggest supporters, and they're there at every single one of my fights. Yeah.
Who's your favorite fighter of all time? Doesn't have to be.
Yeah, that's a great question. I always loved Sugar Ray Leonard growing up. When I first started boxing, I loved Marco Antonio Barrera as well. I loved Kostya Zou. I obviously, Floyd Mayweather is obviously a genius in the ring. I love watching Floyd Mayweather fight. I also love like the likes of Roy Jones, and I'm just a huge boxing fan, really.
Because I saw you, you know, like the first times you were aggressive, but then, you know, you showed me that you also can box, and that was yeah, pretty cool. You know, when I saw you boxing a little bit, actually, you have a lot of abilities. Well, yeah. You're like me. You like to go over people when you're fighting, I mean.
I know, yeah. If I get a chance to stop them, I'll stop them. Yeah. I definitely am. I love, obviously, it's great to be able to adapt in the ring as well. I obviously love to fight and stand there and fight, probably a bit too much at times, but I can step back and box on the outside as well.
Yeah, you know, I have a question from people here. It's kind of interesting. It says, how do you handle fear?
That's actually a good question. I think even just stepping into the ring, I always know that I'm 100% prepared, and I don't leave any stone unturned. Every time I'm training, every single day, I put everything into every single session. This is my life. And I think my preparation and how hard I train gives me the confidence every time I step into the ring. But I also have a fantastic team of people around me as well. And anytime I am feeling a bit more nervous than you or feeling fearful, I can open up to them and talk to them as well. And I think that's really important, to be able to talk to your team and be transparent with your team.
Yeah, nice. You got Eddie Hearn saying hello. He says, Katie Taylor, you got him there.
Yeah, that's great. Eddie's fun.
Yeah. And then I got a question from Argentina specifically. Words about Victoria Bustos.
Oh, yeah, Victoria Bustos, massive fight. A great fight. And I think she was a very, very technical fighter. It was a very, very cagey fight, actually. She's actually a very, very clever fighter, Victoria is. So, yeah, that was a really, really interesting fight. I wish her all the best in the future.
What else I got here? Let me see. I'm just checking. There's a lot of people connected, so I just... Eddie, when is the fight going to happen? I want to be there. But, you know, I'm with this lockdown, the borders aren't closed until August 31st for me. I can't fly until August 31st. So actually, in the fall, is that when I can go out?
Yeah. We still don't know when the flight is going to happen. I think it's going to be in August sometime. But everything's still a bit uncertain right now. We don't really know what's happening. The flight was obviously supposed to happen May 1st, and that was obviously, or May the 2nd, I think. So that was obviously postponed. But yeah, I hope it's going to happen in August sometime.
So you got a Spanish contender asking when you're going to fight her. Medium Gutierrez, he's asking me when. That's specific what she's asking right now.
Yeah, I have to fight. It's one at a time, isn't it? As I said, I can only fight one person at a time.
Look, I like this question because if it was for me, I would have been an athlete. It's like, walk me through the Olympic experience. You know, I'm winning the gold medal. Somebody asked what I am asking too, because I would like to know what exactly you felt that in that time.
Yeah, that was amazing actually, because ever since I was 9 or 10 years of age, I always had a dream of winning the Olympic gold. So that dream just became my life. So every single day I woke up dreaming of becoming an Olympic champion. So to realize a childhood dream was one of the greatest days of my whole life. And it was just amazing just to see hear the national anthem and to see the Irish flag going up.
Yeah. And then it's like, I read something like, you're the closest, they said that you're the closest to royalty in Ireland. that's what I read.
I don't actually know about that, but I think it's Conor McGregor.
Well, and look, let me see where, because I got a very good question from here, from Ellie Sekback. You know Sekback?
Yeah, I love his video.
He's asking you about what do you think about Tyson's return.
Mike Tyson.
Yep.
Yeah, really, he definitely looked fantastic on the pads, doesn't he? I've seen a video of him on the pads, and oh my gosh, he's still so explosive. He's still so powerful. But who's going to be his opponent? I seen that you did an exhibition with Evander Holyfield before.
Yeah, opponent. I love it, and I handled the fear. But yeah. I got to tell you one. When he started moving the pecs, and Jimmy Lennon said that he was a four-time world champion, I was looking any way possible out of it, but I was in already.
That was amazing. That must have been a great experience to share the ring with, like, Evander Holyfield.
Yeah. Okay. Look what I found. Look what I found.
Oh, yes. Jorge Linares. Yeah.
You won the title. I sent this picture to you that day.
He's incredible.
Okay, look, you are the better representation of Ireland than Conor. I admire him as an athlete, but I feel your humility, your humbleness is more typical of Irish people. How is Irish people? I've never been in Ireland. I would love to.
Yeah, you should. Ireland's a beautiful country. The people are very, very friendly. Their sense of humor is like no other.
Well, yeah. There's one thing, I love scotch, so I don't. Yeah. I love whiskey.
There's plenty of whiskey in Ireland, so you're okay. Yeah.
Oh my God! Look at all. You got a lot of people. Like, Katie, you're a better boxing technician than most of the men.
Thank you.
And there's a lot of people saying, okay, what's this? Can you give me any tips on becoming a champion?
That's a good question. I guess for me, I think just making sure that you actually love your sport is so important. Boxing is a tough sport as it is, so you have to love the sport and just give it 100%, and every single day just show up. And there are going to be days when you're not in the mood for training, but it's still important to show up every single day. I think those days are the difference between winning and just show up, give it 100%, and just make sure you enjoy your sport.
Yeah, and there you go. Another question. Which fight you will never forget?
From one of my fights or
yeah, your fights. Yes, your fights.
I think All of them, really. Any world title fight, they're always really, really memorable fights. But it was actually unbelievable to be on the undercard of Anthony Joshua versus Klitschko. That was a history making fight, and I think there was 90,000 people in the stadium for the main event. The atmosphere was absolutely electric, and I never in a million years thought I'd be boxing on such great undercards and such great shows. But that was definitely a history show.
Why are you so shy? you're not shy when you lace up the gloves. You're not shy at all.
I'm actually just a naturally very quiet person. I never really have a lot to say. But once I put on the gloves, I'll do whatever it takes to win the fight.
Yeah, I keep looking at, you know, there's the tons of questions, you know, but I want to know more about you. What's your favorite food? Like mine, it's pizza and pasta for me.
Oh yeah, I actually love pasta. A huge chocoholic, would you believe? I love chocolate. So when I'm making weight, I have to stop eating chocolate. And that's when I become I'm not a nice person when I'm making weight. Like I can't have any chocolate. But yeah, I'm a huge chocoholic. Yeah.
Did you think you achieve everything in boxing, in women's boxing? What's your? I read a lot about you leaving a legacy.
Yeah.
What's your main goal after? And like for you beat Amanda Serrano, what it specific is afterwards? You know, what do you want after, out of this sport? You know, you gave up soccer for this.
Yeah. It's always been my passion. I've always wanted to leave a great legacy behind me, and you know, this is about the money for me. It's not about the fame. I just want to leave a great legacy, and I want to continue to break the boundaries for the next generation. I had a huge part to play in women's boxing, getting into the Olympic Games, and that was a huge privilege for me. And I want to just continue to leave that legacy. I want to be known as one of the best female boxers in the world. So for that to happen, I have to just continue to win. I have to continue to improve, and I just have to keep going.
You continue to improve, you're going to beat all the girls out there, and nobody will fight you.
Yeah, no, there's definitely a lot of room for improvement, which is a great thing. I'm sitting here as an undisputed champion, but I'm still working on a lot of things. I feel like the best.
When was the last time you beat a boy in the ring? I don't need to know after.
The ring, I don't know. I have a lot of great sparring partners over here. I've sparred the boys all the time, actually, and ever since I have started boxing, I've always sparred with the boys, as well as a few girls as well, but mostly with the boys. So I'm very, very appreciative of that, really.
Oh my God! Then they start writing things. Okay, so Katie, I'm gonna leave you today. You know, got a couple of things. I know you might be training, or I don't know if you have the second workout today.
Yeah.
I know you. You know, I know we're in lockdown, but I still have tons of work to do.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah.
I hope the fight happens on September. So, but I don't hope that for you, but for me, in order to be in the Amanda Serrano fight.
Yeah, I'm not sure when it's gonna happen, but they said in August, hopefully, but maybe it will be in September sometime. I'm not sure, but yeah, I hope you can be there yourself. I really do. I hope you can. That was great.
And remember, you're my ambassador, and I admire you very much for what you do.
It's always the box for the WBA belt, and my
win. Is it oldest of all? Is it oldest of the title? The first one since 1921. The first champion was Jack Dempsey.
All right, yeah, well.
That was July. The first ever sanctioned fight was July 2nd, 1921.
Right, yeah, that's amazing.
Yeah, that's great. And I will have to go back on the story of the females. You know, people, all-minded directors, they didn't want it. But yeah. At the end of the day, we had to accept it, you know.
No, that's great. You actually have done so much in promoting female boxing over the last few years. So thanks so much for that. You really have been a huge supporter of female boxers. So it really means a lot.
Okay. Thank you, Kitty. Take care. Keep safe. Bye.